Hello everyone, welcome to Botany National Channel for UPSC examination. In today's video, we are going to discuss the UPSC mains examinations botany paper number 1. That is, in 2019, like every year, UPSC has conducted the UPSC mains examination, in which the botany optional is also one of the subject. So if you are preparing for the botany optional for UPSC examination, you should go thoroughly through this paper so that you will have the idea about how and from where these questions were asked. In this video, we will discuss thoroughly what is the source for these particular questions and what is the level of these questions. So before starting the video, I would request you to join our Telegram channel on the Telegram platform of the same name, that is Botany Optional for UPSC examination, so that you will not miss any update relating with the Botany Optional channel. Alright. Now when we see the mains examination question paper, first you will see the page of instructions. In this, the particular instructions were given that how to solve this particular question paper. Now see, there are total of the 8 questions divided into the 2 sections, both printed in the Hindi as well as in the English. That is, there are total 8 number of questions and these are divided into 2 subsections and they were printed in both the languages, that is in Hindi as well as in the English. But the candidate has to attempt 5 questions in all, right? That is, out of the 8 questions, you just have to attempt the 5 questions. Alright. See, question number 1 and the question number 5 are compulsory and out of the remaining, the 3 are to be attempted, choosing at least one from each section. That is, question number 1 and question number 5 are compulsory. That is, you will not get any option for this particular questions. But from the remaining 6 questions, you just have to attempt the 3 questions just by adhering to the one condition, that is at least one question from each section. Alright. Then the number of marks were carried by the questions are indicated against it. That is, whatever the question is there, against that the number of marks were indicated. Now you should write down the answer, that is medium, authorized in the admission certificate. That is, when we apply for the UPSC examination, they ask us to specify the language for the mains examination. So if you have mentioned the English language for the mains examination, you should go for the English language only. And if you have mentioned the Hindi language or any other language for the mains examination, you should go with that accordingly. All right. So they have clearly mentioned that the no marks will be given for answer written in a medium other than the authorized one. All right. So there is a word limit for each question, which is specified in the particular question. You should adhere to it specifically. All right. So adding more content above the word limit will cost you some marks, right? So you should adhere to the word limits given in the question. Then diagram, figures, whenever required, may be drawn in a space provided for the answering itself. That is, if a particular question has a one sheet for the answer, and if you want to draw the diagram, you should draw the diagram in that particular portion only. You should not ask for any separate sheet for this diagram or figures. Then the attempts of the question shall be counted in the sequential order. That is, the first 5 questions will be taken for the evaluation. So you should carefully choose which question to answer and which question to not. Alright. So because here the first five questions they take into consideration for the evaluation. If you attempt these questions partly, still they will be counted in the first 5. Right. Now, for any reason, if you left some blank pages in the answer sheet, you should struck this off so that there will be no confusion for the evaluation of your paper. Alright. So all these are instructions you should carefully read before writing down the answers in the examinations. Now let us consider the question number 1. And now this question number 1 is divided into 5 sub questions, that is A, B, C, D, and E. And the marks for each is indicated here. That is 10 marks for first sub question, for second 10, third 10, fourth 10, and fifth 10. That is 5 questions total having the marks of 50. That is, the question number 1 is divided into 5 sub questions, which will give you the 50 marks, right? Now in that, they have specified that answer should not exceed the 150 words each, right? So you should write down the answer only in a 150 words. So each question should not have more than 150 words. Now, as we have discussed earlier, the question were typed in both the languages, that is Hindi as well as in the English. So see the first sub question, that is mycorrhizal association and its importance to the plant. You just have to describe the mycorrhizal association and it is important and what importance is provided to the plants. As you know, these are very simple and the basic questions, because the content relating with the answer of this particular question can be found in the 12th NCERT itself, that you only have to describe the mycorrhizal association and what importance is provided to the plants. As you know, mycorrhizal relationship, it's a relationship between the fungi and the roots of higher plants, right? So if you have the basic knowledge, you can easily attempt this particular question, because these are fungus and the roots of higher plants having the mutualistic and symbiotic relationship among them, and due to this relationship, the fungi getting nutrition from the plant, while the plant roots have the larger surface area for the absorption of water. So in such a way, the fungi as well as the roots of the higher plants have benefit from this particular association. So second sub question is differentiation between the bioremediation and the bioleaching. The process of bioremediation and bioleaching are very closely associated, but there are certain basic differences between these two processes, and you have to differentiate these particular differences in this particular answer. All right. For this, you will get the 10 marks. The nature and significance of plant endophytic relationship. You have to describe the plant endophyte relationship. This is coming from the plant pathology section of the UPSC mains syllabus of the Botany optional. Now, in a plant pathology, now see, most of the endophytes, that is those organisms which live inside the plants, mostly the fungi and the bacteria, and how they interact with their host, and whether these relationships are positive or the negative in nature, you have to specify all these in this particular answer. That is the nature and significance of these plant endophyte relationships. All right. The next question is about the alternation of heteromorphic generation in the bryophytes. As you know, the alternation of generation exists in the bryophytes, and you have to describe in particular the alternation of heteromorphic generations in the bryophytes. Again, you can find this topic in any graduation book, because this is a general trend found in the bryophytes, and if you have any basic bryophyte books, you will find this particular topic very elaborately explained. The next question is, you have to draw the well-labeled longitudinal section of the capsule of Funaria. That is again the very simple question. You have to draw the capsule of Funaria. So by only drawing the capsule and well labeling it, you will get the 10 marks. Now let's move to the second question. In the second question, they have divided it in the three parts, A, B, and C. Now, the part A of the question carries 20 marks, part B, 15 marks, and part C, 15 marks, hence total making to the 50. Now, see, first sub question, what are the characteristic features, means of reproduction, and economic importance of the ascomycetes? As you know, ascomycetes is the group of fungi. And in this particular question, you have to answer their characteristic feature first, then their means of reproduction in a second, and their economic importance in the third. So you have to give this answer in a three phases: first phase, second phase, and the third phase. In the first phase, you have to write the characteristic features. In the second phase, means of reproduction. And in a third phase, the economic importance of the ascomycetes. If you elaborate all these three, you will get the 20 marks for this particular question. The second sub-question is describe characteristics and replication in the viroids. Two-level answer of this question. In the first level, you have to describe the characteristics of the viroids, and in the second phase, you have to describe the replication in the viroids. Both these answers in this particular question, you will get the 15 marks for the same. The third sub-question is, what are the critical features of heterospory and seed habit in pteridophytes? As you know, if you have graduation or post-graduation in the botany, then you will come across about this particular question many a times, right? Because it's a very typical question relating with the bryophytes, because the seed habit and the heterospory were originated in these particular plant groups, right? So you have to answer this particular question also in two phases. That is, first you have to describe the heterospory and then the seed habit which is found in the pteridophytes. For this particular question, you will get the 15 marks. Okay. Now let us consider the third question, which is divided into three subsections, that is A, B, and C. The first sub-question carries the 20 marks, second sub-question carries 15, and the third sub-question carries the 15 marks, total making it to the 50 marks. Let us see the first sub-question. Write the names, causal agent, symptoms, control measures of yellow vein in okra and tendu disease of the wheat. So again, you can see they split the question into two. That is, first disease relating with the okra and second disease related with the wheat. In the first disease of the okra, that is yellow vein disease of okra, you have to give the causal agent, symptoms, and control, right? You have to do the same for the wheat. That is, you have to provide, that is, the causal agent, then symptoms, and the control measures for the tendu disease of wheat. So if you provide both these accurately, you will get all the 20 marks for this particular question. Again, this question is coming from the pathology. All right. The next sub question is comment on structure and ecological and physiological importance of the leaf of azolla. As you know, azolla is quite an important plant from the many point of view, and you have to describe the structure and ecological and physiological importance of its leaf. For this, you will get the 15 mark. Again, this question is subdivided into five sections, that is structure, then ecological role, then physiological importance. All these carry the 5, 5, and 5 marks, making it total to the 15 marks. All right. The next step question is, compare the thallus form of the brown and the green alga. Again, the very basic and simple question. That is, you have to compare the thallus of both these group, that is the brown algae thallus and the green algae thallus. And by comparing those, you have to write down their characteristic features. All right. And for this, you will get the 15 marks. The fourth question, again divided into three parts, A, B, and C. The first part, that is A part carrying 20 marks, B part 15 marks, and C part 15 marks, right? The first question is, the compare and contrast the system of classification of Bentham and Hooker and Hutchinson. Add a note on their merits and demerits. So this can be found somewhat complex in nature because you have to provide the systems of classification which are given by the Bentham and Hooker and the Hutchinson. By giving both these systems of classification, you later have to add their merits as well as their demerits. For this particular question, you will get the 20 marks. What causes the anomalous secondary growth in the dicot plants? Now, as you know, dicot plants has this anomalous secondary growth, and you just have to explain what causes this anomalous secondary growth. And by just discussing the proper reason, proper causes for anomalous secondary growth, you will straight away get the 15 marks. In the BSc honors, you have definitely studied this all in a very detail, right? So it's quite easy to answer this question and get these 15 marks. The next sub question is, state the application of microbiology in the agriculture. So you have to give the application of microbiology in the agriculture. This particular topic is largely described in one of our videos last year. So you should go for this particular video and you will get the complete answer for this particular question. All right. Next question is the fifth question. And as we have discussed earlier, the question number one and the question number fifth are compulsory, that you do not have options for this particular questions, right? So this fifth question is compulsory question. And in this, they have asked you to describe the following in 150 words only. That is, you have to stick to the word limit of 150 for each sub question. All right. So the fifth question is divided into five parts. Now see the first sub question. You have to describe the importance of haploid production from the pollen grains. That is, the haploid plant production from the pollen grains, it is quite related with the plant tissue culture. And you have to describe the importance of the haploid plant productions. That is, generally we have the diploid plants, and in nature we have diploid plants, but by using the artificial technique like plant tissue culture, we can create the haploid plants as well by using the pollen grains. So what is the importance of producing the haploid plants? You have to describe it, and for this you will get the 10 marks. Then the second sub question is hydrocarbons yielding energy crops and advantages of the biodiesel. That is, as you know, this is the question from the current topics, because the plants which are used for, which are the hydrocarbon yielding crops, and they were used for creating the biodiesel. You have to describe these plants and how these plants were used to produce the biodiesel, and for this you will get the 10 marks. The next question is the steps in the production of the somatic hybrids and their advantage. So you have to describe the somatic hybrids and their advantage. For this, we have a video on our channel. You can check out these videos, and I will give the link in the description box so that you will get the video directly. All right. The next is illustrate the Krull's anatomy in a typical C4 plants. Again, I am saying that although the UPSC tends to ask the question at the graduation or the post-graduation levels, but sometimes they ask the very basics question, which are nothing but from the 11th and the 12th textbooks. So this is one of such a question, that is, you have to describe the Krull's anatomy which is found in the C4 plants. This is quite easy, and you will find this in a NCERT textbooks. All right. The last sub question of the fifth question is paleontology and its significance. So you just have to give the paleontology. It is nothing but the study of pollen grains, and you have to provide its significance. We have uploaded the video relating with this last year, so check that video as well, so that you will have all the knowledge relating with this particular question. All right. Now the sixth question is divided into three sub questions, A, B, and C. The first question carries 20 marks, second carries 15 marks, and third carries the 15 marks, making it total to the 50 marks. Now see, the first question, define herbarium and give methods of its preparation, and also mention the names of the major herbaria. So this question is totally dependent on the herbarium, and these herbariums were used to preserve the or create the plant monologues. You have to describe their method of preparation, that is how herbariums got created, and also you have to mention the five major herbaria. For this, you will get the 20 marks. All right. This second sub question, write the botanical names and families of the plant yielding the beverages, narcotics, and the gum. Again, this question is divided into three sub questions. the first part, second part, and the third part. And in every part, you have to do just one thing. Just provide the botanical name and families of the plants yielding beverages. This is the first part. Then plant yielding narcotics. This is the second part. And plant yielding glums. This is the third part. Starting with this, we have many videos on our YouTube channel. So you straight away go to the video and you will get the five examples for each category. That is for gums, beverages, and the narcotics. Mark-wise, the every sub-portion carries the 5, 5, and 5 weightage so that you will get the 15 marks at the end, right? The identifying characters, floral diagram, floral formula of verbenaceae and liliaceae. That is, you have to give the identifying characters, then floral diagram and floral formula first for the verbenaceae and then for the liliaceae. As you know, this liliaceae family belongs to the monocot, while the verbenaceae belongs to the dicot. So they ask one example from the dicot plant and other from the monocot plant. So you have to describe these families by giving their identifying characters, then the floral formula and the floral diagram. All right, and for this you will get the 15 marks. Now let us consider the seventh question, which is divided into three parts, A, B, and C. A portion carries the 20 marks, B portion carries 15 marks, C portion carries 15 marks. Now see, the first question, highlight the main feature of Vavilio centers of origin for the crop plants. As you know, Vavilio has given the many centers of the origin of the crop plant, that is the primary centers and the secondary centers. You have to describe all these centers about the origin of crop plants. For this, you will get the 20 marks. Now see, the next sub question is, define the totipotency and discuss the cytodifferentiation in plants. Again, this question is coming from the plant tissue culture. And in this plant tissue culture, we have the concept of totipotency and how the cytodifferentiation occurs in plant. So if you describe both these, you will get the 15 marks. Then how embryology is useful in the taxonomy, that is how the embryological characters can be used for the taxonomical classification. For this, you will get the 15 marks. Now let us see the eighth question and the last question, which is divided into three parts, A, B, and C. Now see, A part carries the 20 marks, B part carries the 15, and C part carries the 15, which making it total to the 50 marks. Now see, the first sub question, see how many types of embryo sac known among the angiosperm and describe their formation and give example for each. That is, again, this question is divided into three subparts. That is, you have to give the various types of the embryo sacs which are found in the angiosperm, which we have discussed in our earlier videos as well. Then you have to describe their formation, that is how they were got created, and you should provide example for each of them. So for this, you will get the 20 marks. The second sub question is, discuss the silent features of greentails, why they are regarded as a most evolved gymnosperm. So this question is typically coming from the gymnosperm, and in any graduation book you will find the content about the greentails, and for this you will get the 15 marks, right? The last question is, what are the different stages of micropropagation and maintain its order and mention its advantages. Micropropagation is again relating with the plant tissue culture, and you have to give the importance of this micropropagation as well. So this is a two-part question. First part carries 7.5 marks and second part carries 7.5 marks. For this, you will get the total of 15 marks. If you observe carefully about this paper, the question from the plant tissue culture can be found nearly in the every section, right? So the plant tissue culture as a method to produce the many plants at the same time is quite famous in these days of rapid deforestation, because the plant tissue culture can provide an alternative to produce large number of plants in a relatively less time. All right. So while discussing this botany optional paper for UPSC mains examination 2019, we came across some very simple questions. You can judge that this question paper is not so tough and quite easy. If you are graduated in a botany, you can easily answer all these questions, right? So I will highly recommend to use the books at your graduation levels, because all these questions are covered in the graduation level books, right? So and if you have a master's degree in the botany, then you will not miss any of these questions, right? So this is quite easy from the graduation and post-graduation point of view. And some of these can even be found in the 12th or the 11th NCERT textbooks, all right? Whatever the books we have used in our graduation and the post-graduation, or say from the 11th, 12th, if you go through this sequence, that is first from the 11th, 12th examination, second from the graduation, and third to the post-graduation, then you will not have any chance to miss the question from the UPSC mains examination for the botany optional. So thank you for watching this video. Please like the video, share this video, and if you have any doubt, please make comment in the comment box. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe to the Botany Optional channel for UPSC examination. In the next video, we will see about the paper number 2, right? So we will discuss paper number 2 in the next video. So stay tuned for the same, all right? So thank you very much for watching this video. See you in the next one.